I'm Alan, I play the bass guitar.
I'm Ryan.
I'm Jeff.
I'm Derek.
So we just got here from Florida. We drove our van up 1,000,000,000,000 hours.
Very uncomfortable.
We would have gone home because we got denied entrance to Canada.
Canada did not want Poison the Well to rock out.
This whole 3,000 kid fest thing, we decided that we would take 4 days off, spend $70 a day on the van for the 4 days we have off just to come play here for these fucking awesome hardcore kids.
Thank you.
We're Shiloh from Poughkeepsie, New York.
Nowadays.
Holland, Oklahoma, Florida, New York, everywhere, but based out of Poughkeepsie, New York.
Worldwide hardcore. We begged and begged, and at the last second, they're like, there's a spot for you guys. I guess we can put you on for like 5 seconds.
So I think they're giving us like, what, 5 minutes to play?
Right.
We drove from Poughkeepsie here just to play the show today.
Just pillaging the East Coast.
East Coast pillage.
Buried Alive, Scott, Joe, Matt. We hail from the wonderful city of Buffalo, New York. What we're doing right now is playing Hellfest here in Syracuse. It's a Saturday afternoon. There's about 8 million people here. And we're playing a little later, right after our good friends Reach the Sky. Just been doing our thing, playing our third consecutive Hellfest here.
Pretty psyched because these are our stomping grounds. Syracuse is close like our hometown, so got a lot of friends here. A lot of dudes excited to mosh it up for us and jump around and act like idiots.
I'm just thinking, I don't know, it's going pretty good. Found out the place is air conditioned in there. Good news. It won't be a sauna. Make it a little more enjoyable. No. The show has to be over sometime at a decent hour, I hear. So, you know,
the fest won't drag until 4 in the morning.
An all around good evening. You get to hang out all day. Play a little bit, work up a little sweat, and then go out and party in Syracuse.
That's what we're about, having fun, seeing our friends, and jumping on fucking heads.
Yeah. What's up, everybody? We're Brothers Keeper. Welcome to Hellfest 3.
This is our third year, and we're glad to keep the tradition alive. And I don't know.
For some reason, we keep getting asked back.
With 60 bands playing Hellfest, we decided to play a set full of Misfits covers tonight. We played the last two Hellfests, so we wanted to do something a little different, make us stand out. Whether kids hate the idea that we're doing it or love the idea that we're doing it, they'll remember that we're doing it because it's different. It's not something that any other band's doing. It's not something that we've ever done before.
Whether or not it makes a strong impact, like positive or negative, it'll have people talking and talking about Brothers Keeper, you know, and out of all those bands, like, it's hard to do something that makes people remember you, and that's all we want is to, like, you know, we want to keep on the edge, just try to push and do new things and keep people on their toes. And the hardcore scene, it becomes so cliche to just do so many things and go with the flow. We're just always trying to, like, you know, defy assumptions that kids have about us and about bands in general, and just keep doing new stuff, pushing the envelope.
And if you don't like the Misfits, you suck.
Begin. Sir.
Sir.
Tree falls over the Palisade Parkway. Sir, you're forgetting the answer.
and you're forgetting.
But we're here in Syracuse. At some place, I don't know, like the fifth place that we were supposed to be on this day.
Step into my office.
Seems pretty cool.
Cause you're fucking full.
A lot of good bands. I didn't even think the show was going to happen, but it did, so I guess that's cool. First day of our tour, so we're kind of psyched.
Ready to rock.
You can tell.
Drive back and forth across the country.
Thank you. I'm Eric from Maine.
I'm Nick from Maine.
From Massachusetts.
From Massachusetts. And this is our first time at Hellfest. We pretty much, our booking guy said that this would, the whole tour is pretty much booked around this show because it was going to be so huge. So we're expecting just utter craziness, and we heard that it was going to be utter craziness.
I mean, we get pretty high expectations, but we came up and it's like pretty insane right now.
After all the turmoil from the last couple days, it's so amazing. It's such a miracle that it came through.
Yeah.
A lot of people came together to make this work, and it just shows you how hardcore this show is. This is such a hardcore show. It's the coolest show. It's like there's thousands of people here from all over the country.
All over the world.
And it's not corporate. It's like, and there's people driving by that have no idea what's going on. Everday sort of Joes that are driving by, and it's mind-boggling how many people have come together for this. This is like the biggest hardcore event.
Yeah. They probably will ever play too.
Yeah.
All right, Hellfest. Let's fucking do this.
We're a rock and roll band called Every Time I Die from Buffalo, New York. We're about to jam Hellfest. You know, we came in the bulldozer. It took us about 3.5 days to get here from Buffalo. So we're probably going to turn around like right after the set. We got to clear out of here. We're not too good in reverse, so we're just going to take down a few trees and shit. And then boot home. I got to get my spine pierced tomorrow.
There's a lot of dirty kids here today.
Yeah, a lot of dirty kids.
Five of which we are.
Yeah.
So we'll turn right in.
We're going to try to load some dirt into our bulldozer and try to just shovel it in there.
Take it home.
Maybe it's people feel more comfortable. Like
it's fucking dirt fast. From California, and we got to Hellfest in a fucking van with a TV, a VCR,
PlayStation,
a fan, a couple magazines, some bitchin' records, and whatnot.
Canadian.
We're looking forward to playing this Hellfest jammy here. We're gonna turn this mother out.
We are the cutest band at Hellfest. We have the best hair, the best clothes, best style.
Yeah, we have the best hair for sure. I think so.
We reached this guy from Boston, and we had the opportunity to play last year's Hellfest when it was hot as blazes all day long, and it was the most brutally excruciating day of my life, but it was also one of the best, and one of the best shows, festivals, anything that we've ever played. One of the things last year that I regret the most, or what I was never able to pull together, was a video of the whole thing. And there were kids that were saying that they had tapes, and I never got a tape of it because it was such a classic day for us. And like, you know, like the sets of Buried Alive and 10 Yard Fight and Voices Fire put on, those are like things I always wanted to see and I never got a chance to. So I think it's pretty amazing that so many people have come together to keep this show happening, and then for all the labels and the people involved to get the video and the online internet stuff that they do to, you know, put this music on the internet. All that happening here just will add to the, you know, just to how powerful much of a show this was. So if you were somebody who was here,
you know, it's going to be a great scrapbook of like what was available and what you saw. And if you weren't there, then you're going to kick yourself in the ass, and hopefully you'll be back here next year for the next Hellfest, because I'm sure this thing will grab everything.
This happens to be one of the greatest fucking days of my entire life. All of these people here together, everybody pulling together to put off what's going to be one of the greatest shows I've ever seen. And what makes it so special is that everybody made this what it was. It's not the bands, it's not the promoters, it's not the people with their names and their lights. It's every single fucking person in here who made it what it's worth. And thank you very much for doing so well on it. Everybody's a star from Boston, Massachusetts.
Mike, we're playing Walls of Jericho, and we're here today to rock and roll Hellfest 2000.
I drove by myself. I drove with a couple people. They drove off. I was actually pretty worried about this fest, considering that all that's what happened the other day. Couldn't get a hold of anyone, so I thought it wasn't going to go on. I thought I was going to be stuck without a band, yeah. Or they were going to be stuck without me, because I thought I was going to go.
We kind of, because there was no tour, we weren't on tour, we're just doing one show, we're just coming here to play, and we were more coming to see the whole show. You know, the fact that we were playing was just an added bonus. So yeah. We kind of all went separately. In our van, there was three of us from the band, and then there was a couple guys that just came to hang out with us, see the show. And we actually took two cars, because our van is being really bad right now, and our transmission doesn't work. So we had to drive, we could only drive about 55 miles an hour, and the whole time it was really messed up. And we had to stop at every restaurant and just hang out. We were playing Tony Hawk pretty much the entire time. That's pretty much all we did. Our trip was about 11 hours.
Damn.
Pretty good. Yeah, it was a good time.
Damn.
We'll be right back. Hi, we're Nora. Just like their song. It's good, right? We're not good at this at all.
We really shouldn't be allowed to talk to people.
Yeah, we should just play music. We shouldn't be allowed to talk ever. I don't know, what were we saying? Nora, we played all three Hellfests, so we're pretty cool in that regard.
Yeah, we played all three of them so far.
Yeah.
It, you know, it's escalated as it's gone along.
Yeah.
To the point where this...
Now they have PAs. The first one, they didn't have a PA, so they've advanced in you know...
It's a fucking life of its own.
Yeah.
No, it's kicked ass. It's like probably the most people we play to.
Ever.
All year. Yeah, ever. Fuck that, dude. Stadium tour coming up.
Yeah.
No, it's awesome to get up in front of all these people. Nah. You know, try not to waste their fucking time.
We took Ryan from Pours in the Well, we taught him the songs this morning, and he's filling a guitar, you know.
And that should be very interesting.
That should be very interesting, being that, like, you know, he just learned them about an hour ago, and we're playing soon.
There was a lot of demand involved yesterday.
Yeah, so basically everyone was stressing about it happening, and...
Everyone's baking in the sun.
We're all sunburnt now. We look like fucking
Red
Lobster.
You see how my fucking forehead looks? I look like a jackass. It's all because of
that.
That's not why
I
look like a jackass. It's might be your... Never mind.
You have no sleeves.
Dude, I was fucking... You know.
Dude, he's going 80s style, man. Fucking Billy Idol'd out.
No. We think it's fucking
but
awesome
it's cool.
That we got
everyone
to
came together, and even the cops were nice, and the kids were cool, and no one got beat up with batons or maced or anything.
Rubber,
so that's always
rubber
good.
Bullets.
Rubber bullets are suck.
You guys
know
the words. Get the fuck up here. You feel it? Have fun. We'll be right back.
good first, sound good second. Yeah. Gold mic stands, gold
strings,
mic
lots of gold, strings
lots
are
of
not.
Gold shit, lots of fucking rock and roll. In our own hardcore fashion.
Lots of handlebars and...
Just good times, all positive atmosphere.
Good times.
People having a good time, moshing, fucking... Jumping on
never
each other
too old,
shit.
Never too young for moshing it up and singing along.
We just want to fucking play a blistering set. Show all these people how to fucking rock and roll.
Just came to rock out, you know, have fun, sing about girls, sing about chicks. I mean, AC/DC did it, so we're gonna fucking
why the fuck
do
can't
it.
We?
Why can't we?
Okay, I got a little story for you. And it goes a little something. Oh my god, this.
Probably the biggest display of what hardcore kids talk about, that they're all about. And a lot of kids are like, you know, all talk, no mosh. But this today and yesterday, everyone really like stood up for what I guess they say they believe in.
Yeah, yesterday, I mean, we were almost seconds away from having no Hellfest, and everyone decided, guess what? We drove a long way. We're part of the community just like everyone else. We're like, let's do this.
A good 1,000 kids just sat down in a parking lot and made this happen.
Hardcore band. We're not really, we don't champion any sort of ideal or belief, except the only ideal that we sort of champion is
to have fun,
to be yourself and have fun, and to not let the world bear down on you so much and influence the way that you react to other people and to the world. So I think that I don't know, Bane isn't like a straight edge band. Bane isn't like a vegan band.
We're a punk rock band.
We're the freest band in hardcore. We have no soundbite to attach to our.
We have no labels, no nothing.
It's such a miracle that it came through.
Yeah.
And this video is totally, it's awesome. It sort of explores another medium that's coming up in hardcore. You know, like filmmaking. Not just zines, and it's not just bands recording anymore. It's other things. You know, it's the internet. It's all kinds of different mediums, and this is totally proof of it, and it's exciting. It's a really exciting time, and I'm glad that it's being documented, because it's maybe the last time it's this exciting again.
Come on.
and we have probably no way to get home.
Oh,
I think our van is kind of dead, but we made it, so that's really all that matters.
Yeah. So. Well, I'm glad it's still going on.
Yeah.
I swear to God, I thought that one kid, I don't know his name, but he was standing up on that big, huge trailer. And I so thought the cops were just going to, like, take him down.
Yesterday?
Yeah.
She got here early.
Yeah, he was preaching. Yeah. He was doing the whole,
we
won't go till we rock. No. We're just like, we don't want to get arrested, dude. They're putting on gear. Their cops are all gearing up.
Yeah, by the time we showed up, like, there was a guy that said Hellfest info written on a pizza box. And that was pretty much what we had to work with. And then the guy that did give us directions to this club gave us the wrong directions, and he was the guy that was giving directions to everybody. So the fact that anybody is here today is completely amazing.
Yeah, it's still
including
amazing,
ourselves,
though.
We still didn't know how to get here.
This place isn't great. It isn't bad. It's still fucking hotter than hell, though.
Boston, Massachusetts. There's Adam Patterson.
I play drums.
I'm Jonas, I play bass.
Kevin, I sing.
I'm Niraj, I play guitar.
I'm Dan, I also play guitar.
And we're here at the Hellfest. There's a lot of people here. Last night there was, I don't know, 2,000 people. I don't know, I'm really bad at this stuff, but there's been a lot of problems with this thing going on. Lots of people complaining, lots of people having a good time, lots of people getting sunburned. I think for the most part it's something people will remember, though, just because, you know, controversy, they'll remember it. And lots of good bands playing too. We're going on sometime this evening, our first ever Hellfest.
Actually, our first ever really big like festival type show, I believe, so am I not correct?
Yeah, our biggest show we played. We've only been playing shows for about 6 months, so we feel lucky to be involved in this. With all the really great bands that are coming tonight.
Yeah!
around for 6 or 7 years. A lot of people know us, a lot of people don't, but we have what we feel is a different approach to not only music, but our message, which is basically an honest, positive outlook on music and the way we hope to affect the world. So many people have separated form and content to a point where, you know, it's kind of gotten about rocking out lately. And I think a lot of kids are getting disenchanted with it. Our number one goal is to just kind of start some shit in the hardcore scene and stir it up a little bit to get people thinking and, you know, questioning where they stand and really what hardcore is altogether, because I think a lot of people have just been sleeping for the past couple of years.
As a band, we have a lot of different backgrounds and different influences, and we all kind of come together, and I feel that Brothers Keeper has a unique music sound and also the vocal styles. You know, we catch a lot of flack for it, but then again, I'd rather stand out than just be another band that just, you know, follows the same mold.
We really give a shit about what we're doing. You know, we're not here to just be like cool rock band guys. We've been doing it for too long to care about that stuff. We need something to really put our hearts and souls into to keep us going, and that's why we're here today and why we're playing in this band, telling kids to wake the fuck up, get off the couch, quit playing fucking video games all the time, and think about where they stand, not only as a kid in the hardcore scene, but as a person in the world today, you know, because it's all intertwined.
It's just awesome. When we got here, I see so many old friends, and it's like, oh my God. And everyone's so friendly, and I really like being friendly. I like when people are friendly to me. So I just walk around, and I see some guy that I met maybe in Pennsylvania who comes up to me and says, hey, nice set. And I get all emotional. I'm like, oh my God, hey, how's it going? Hey, how's it going? I get really excited, and that's what it means to me, just getting a whole bunch of kids together to appreciate stuff that we create or that everybody creates, and to all relate with it and bond. It's gonna be awesome, and it is awesome when people play, and when we're gonna play, you see all the kids screaming and pointing fingers. You know, kind of makes you feel alive. So that's what it means to me. Hellfest is like just another show, a group of friends just getting together and rocking out.
A lot of friends.
A lot of friends.
Hellfest was also a little bit of trouble.
A little bit of trouble, but all shows are a little bit of trouble. But it's going to be a damn good time, and I can't wait to rock out and have, you know, everybody share what we're trying to create with us.
One King Down brought in full stacks years ago. Everybody laughed at us. Ooh, look like a Pearl Jam. They called us fucking Pearl Jam because we had full stacks. And now everybody rocks full stacks, whatever. Now.
We've one-upped.
We're getting crazy. We got two guitar heads for one guitar, three cabinets, sometimes four cabinets. Breaking new ground yet again. So laugh at us today. Follow us tomorrow.
And
anyways, we're idle hands, and we were supposed to go on about a month-long tour. We were gonna drive up to New York and come back down with the budgets and the Kindles,
But as we were going up to Utah, some idiot like hit the left rail and came back and basically used us as a cushion. He didn't hit his brakes. He just hit us, and we did about 3 or 4 flips, skid for about like 300 or 400 yards. We had equipment like everywhere on the street, blood everywhere, you know, glass everywhere, t-shirts like flying around on the freeway, stickers like scattered about, and basically we have nothing after that. Nothing's left. And we don't have any equipment. Like, Joe's guitar is like split in half, his SG, and it's just pretty crappy, but.
Yeah.
I think our trailer was split in half. We had a wooden trailer, and it was like, one half of it was on the other side of the road, and the other half was like next to where the wall we hit and when we flipped, so.
I mean, the wheels were twisted around each other.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy. It's a pretty insane accident, but at least we're alive, so we're pretty happy, so. Yeah.
Second, everyone crawled out of the car. I'm looking at everything in shock. Like, I can't believe we're alive. And the rest of the guys are going, we'll just pack it up. We'll rent a van, we'll go to the hospital, we'll rent a van, we'll just pack up our stuff, and we'll just finish the tour.
Hey, what's up? We're Killswitch Engage. My name is Mike. I play bass.
I'm Jesse. I'm a vocalist.
Joelle and Adam can't be here. They're packing up all the equipment like they usually are, getting ready to hit the road. Just played Hellfest. Had a fucking killer time. Best show on tour so far.
Definitely.
Unlike some of our old bands, like I was in Overcast before, we tried a completely different route with this band. Using a lot of repetition instead of technicality, a lot more driving riffs, stuff that people can hold onto a bit more and not have to listen to it 20 or 30 times to grasp exactly what's going on. We went straight for emotion and repetition. Those were our two main factors in the band.
Definitely. And I was also the singer for a band called Corinne, and Nothing Stays Gold, and unlike those bands, I twisted the lyrics and made it more positive as opposed to self-inflicted pain, et cetera, et cetera. And that, I think, that gets to be really repetitious after a while. So we're trying to do more of a positive spin as well.
Which is a total different thing for me, because Overcast was the most negative thing I've ever done in my entire life, even though it was the best thing I've ever done. The lyrics were extremely negative and extremely hurtful, and that's the way I liked it.
Thanks.
But this is totally different and brand new, and we're psyched about it.
First Hellfest was out in Auburn, where this one was supposed to be, in a little tiny place that had a kitchen off of it, and it was one of our first shows. I think our demo, I don't even know if we had our demo out. Maybe our, yep, demo just came out, and it was cool because it was like first time we got to play for a lot of people that had traveled and stuff, so we were psyched. There was just the floor, no stage, so we could attack the people, and I definitely remember getting kicked in the face during one of our first songs by someone. I don't know, this is kind of like gone into something wild and crazy, and I kind of feel for all the people that traveled and stuff with all the chaos and stuff. No one knows where to go and stuff. It's easy for us being from Buffalo. We can just make some calls and kind of know the area a little bit better, but there's people from everywhere that are probably not knowing what's going on.
We'll be right back.
been on tour for like 2 weeks now, and this is the last leg of our tour. We're playing this show, then we're going home. It's been awesome. It's an awesome way to end, you know, a tour in front of 3,000 kids. You can't ask for anything better. Most will play in front of ever. Probably the most kids we'll ever play in front of.
Yeah! I can think of a lot of cultures, and I can think of a lot of groups of people. I can think of few that could have done what we did today. I feel like we moved mountains together. Things started out with people telling us, no, we can't, no, we can't, no, we can't. We all said, yes, we could, yes, we could. We could do this. We could do this non-violently. Everyone can have a great time. And whatever it ends on, it'll always end good if it stays in our hearts. The memories will never, ever fade.
Sweet, gnarly, hang time, you know? It was fucking chill. It was a party, you know? It's cool. It's real cool.
Fucking mayhem.
My muscles.
My feet hurt.
Our wrestling team.
Wrestling.
Still in effect.
Oh yeah, brother! Yeah.
Hellfest 2000!
Okay, I just got laid. Alright. I had so much fun playing. Unfortunately, I don't remember most of our set because it just went by like a fucking blur, but it was the best blur of my fucking life, dude. It was great.
It's one of the best things that I've ever been through. It's like, I don't really have the words for how great it is. And how, I mean, so many great bands, and like, it all happened anyway, even though there were so many problems during the road. And it was like three places before this that was shut down, and we got here, and we made it. Like, it's the best. I'll be back next year.
What was it? We're
about to get 6 hours from Barron. You can still all of our best.
C'est une chance pour nous, on n'aimerait sûrement plus ici, et d'avoir pu participer à Hellfest, c'est vraiment bien, bien organisé. Dommage que ça ne s'est pas bien passé au niveau des dates, ça n'a pas été réglé. Moi je me suis bien amusé, voilà. Merci, au revoir.
There's probably 2,000 kids all singing the same shit at the same time, no room for a dance floor, solid sea of hands. Let me see, Converge. What about Converge? I mean, this is Converge right here. Scratch is here. We have his hand is super glued shut. He has this disgusting gash, super glued shut. So, I mean, that'll just give you an indication of the kind of insanity that's transpired this weekend. That's some lovely shit right there. Throwdown was a prison riot. Throwdown was not a dance floor. It was a prison riot. And Poison the Well gave me goosebumps. I got goosebumps. I would agree. This has to be one of the better shows you're ever going to see in your entire lifetime. It was amazing. And the cops have been so fucking terrible.
The number of kids we had is pretty smooth.
No problems. No, I thought it went very well.
Kids are polite.
Yeah, I never see such a polite, courteous bunch of people. It's really no problems at all. Kind of enjoyed it. Don't understand the music, but yeah. Can't enjoy the people.
Different strokes, different folks, just no problem.
I wasn't inside for the last thing, but I heard it was sick. It was so incredible. So every band I ever loved, and it was just crazy. I had the greatest time, met incredible people. It was just the whole weekend.
Oh! Yeah.
That's it?
I have fun.
No, it's right there. It's on that, so you can't lose it.
Fucking good.
It was a beautiful thing. Shit was hot.
Everything's over. I did everything I could in every way possible. All my friends are here. They all helped me. I did everything I could. Festival went down. Nobody got killed. Nobody got hurt. Shit, man. Hopefully, if I don't get enough hate mail, it'll happen again next year. Under a little better conditions, whatever. I hope everybody had fun.
Everybody was cool. There was no fights. And there were, I don't know how many people there were here, like 3,000 people, 2,000 people?
Yeah.
And hardcore is so intense, and to have that much people doing hardcore and swinging and dancing so hard, it's like, and there's no fights. It's like, that is so awesome. And it's like props to all the kids who like did that. You know, like kept it cool. And so that maybe we can have like another one.
This was awesome. It's friends, family, everything. Got a little screwed up, but it was awesome to see everybody, and we saw all the bands. It was awesome. It was family.
Come on, that shit on me.
What'd you think of Hellfest, buddy boy?
I didn't see too much of it, but I liked it. I'm very sweaty. I'm sorry.
If it weren't for my man Brooklyn, I'd have some good shots because he stood in front of me half the time.
Yeah, but also if it wasn't for me, you wouldn't fucking take half the footage you had because you lost the battery.
And
oh,
Yeah, he got the battery and he
filmed. I fucking kicked like 12 kids in the head just to get that shit.
Jonas from Hope Conspiracy, Jonas, you prick, busted my battery off.
It was a cool experience. I mean, it was well worth the drive out here.
Did you have a good time with him?
From
Chicago. Had a great time.
And it was hell getting out here. Kind of hell when we were here. I guess it's fitting it's Hellfest. But it's an experience. Very happy we came.
I have no doubt you'll make it home in an hour.
Yeah. See? You're talking shit. You had to get that little jab in there, dude.
That shit was hot.
Worth every penny, DJ?
Yeah, I guess so.
You spent on it, man?
I really liked my response. I mean, I've had my shirt off for about an hour or so. The response has been really high.
Look at his face, dude. Look at his shit. Who's a man? Get Mike.
This is for all the girls in San Diego who want Devlin. He will be available soon in an area near you.
Hellfest 2001. Good this year, great next year. Hey.
All this is about is fucking communism, dude.
Props to my man, Big Worm, for this weekend.
That was insane at the end. Like, I thought everybody was going to kill each other. Like, kids started, like, robbing the bar upstairs to throw things off the balcony. Like, I grabbed a kid, I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, oh, sorry. And these are tearing down our banners and shit. It was hell.
All in all.
I loved it.
Don't get me on camera. Don't get me on camera. Don't get me on camera.
Get the fuck out of here.
Don't get me on
camera. He's got road rash.
No, it's good.
Poor Lucky was hit by a car. Road rash. I got him dancing behind me. I dropped my camera probably three times. It's got bumps and bruises all over it. And Derek's heart is fucking held together by band-aids.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Hellfest sucked ass because I didn't see my boyfriend.